Governor Newsom last week signed an executive order making California the first state in the nation to respond to the COVID-19 pandemic by taking action to send every registered voter a ballot in the mail for the general election.
We already have the infrastructure built in for drop boxes and other abilities for voters to return ballots quickly and easily. But it made that challenge because voters were already starting to return ballots, and then we switched kind of midstream to this no in-person option.
The look and feel of polling places is going to need to change, and election officials are going to have to add another hat to their responsibilities, and that's a public health official. And again, another challenge for us looking ahead to November.
You can also see by this chart that for general elections, we always see a slightly larger number of people choosing to vote in person. So that's something we definitely have to take into consideration as we make plans for November.
In addition to our increase that we've seen in the use around vote by mail and the proportional use around vote by mail, we know though there are still significant disparities by race, ethnicity, age, and a number of other statuses when it comes to actually using vote by mail. So why do California voters choose vote by mail instead of voting in person? 72% of them said it was more convenient than going to a neighborhood polling place on election day. For polling place voters, overwhelmingly why they choose in some form to use an in-person experience, 97% said it was because that polling place was convenient for them to get to. Specifically of those voters that didn't send a vote-by-mail ballot through the mail, 27% of them said they didn't trust the USPS to get their ballots delivered safely on time, so they weren't using the mail. Rejection rates in California. So vote-by-mail use has increased quite significantly, but of course, vote-by-mail ballots have to be verified. They have to get there on time. The top three rejection rates are always late, signature doesn't match, and no signature, but this does significantly vary by county and by subgroup within county. A significant percentage of ballots are not postmarked or have an unreadable postmark. And what that all means is that increasing awareness about USPS pickup practices and dating one's signature on the ballot envelope could help reduce ballot rejection due to those late postmarks and missing or unreadable postmarks.
You'll see some of the reasons why folks may not be able to use vote by mail and why it's so important. I know the other folks have lifted this up to have safe, accessible in-person voting locations.
Nearly one out of five Latinos who are eligible to vote in California do not yet speak English fluently.
So as we're looking forward to the November election, we do want to be sure that limited English proficient voters who already often have difficulty accessing elections do have their needs met.
It could give them maybe for the first time an opportunity to actually see their ballot and understand that they don't have to vote on everything to be able to participate, and that they could actually have more time maybe to examine and to be able to reach out for assistance if that is needed, you know, from the election officials.
There may be some changes in state procedures, as has been discussed here today, but helping to educate and organize voters will be as crucial as it's ever been to conducting elections in 2020.